The showdown with champions Man United provided one of the games of the season.
Vitreska, slipping Leclerc, Roland slipping Beckett. Dowie's onside. Peter Jones was very well placed to judge. There's no great appeal from Dowie. Leclerc in defence of Irwin, who made contact, going across and having a word with the West Ham striker. Obviously, Leclerc feeling that Dowie made a real meal of that, Andy.
Yeah, well, not one West Ham United player, Mark, was questioning a decision from. I thought he was offside just there. Might well have just been a touch offside. But as he comes across, they're almost meeting each other. I certainly don't think it's a penalty. I don't think Ian Dowie does. He goes down here. But there's a little bit of connection. I think Dennis Irwin and him do go for the ball.
There might be a chance for Dowie here. Oh, Schmeichel's dropped it! But what a recovery to stop Michael Hughes giving West Ham the lead.
Well, that's just lack of concentration. He knows it. It's one of those easy ones that's coming in. He's almost looking what he's going to do with this before he's caught it. He's looking around, he thinks it's easy. And those sort of things can happen, but what a recovery.
Now, Hughes. Dumitrescu. Plenty back for Manchester United. Dumitrescu trying to overturn the odds, though. It's a very bold run. Oh!
Well, when it had gone beyond Schmeichel, we were expecting it to nestle inside that far post. It kept on going, though.
It's only the little bend that keeps it out, man. It just curls away. You can see it curling away. But this is a great example when you back even very good defenders like Gary Pallister. You back them into the area. You drive at them and commit them. They hate it. That's what Dumitrescu's in the side to do. He did it almost perfectly. The only thing lacking, well, was that finish. Great effort.
Becker. And through Pawlowski to Leclerc. It's wider on the left this time. Looking it towards Cantona, who's unmarked. And so too is Solskjaer for second. Great save.
What a save. What skill from Solskjaer. And it was matched by an equally brilliant save from Rurik McCosker, who's had nothing to do for 40 minutes. And then is asked to produce a save. Look at the skill from Solskjaer. Great feet. Great skill. What a block.
Pallister. Collected by Cantona. Solskjaer has made a terrific run. A great pass. And Manchester United have turned the potential into the opening goal. A goal of real quality work between Cantona and Solskjaer.
Well, Mark Rieper tries to step up and play offside, Mark, and gets it wrong. There he goes. And Julian Dix is behind him. Now, you can't do that. If you defend properly, it goes with the run. The run's a good one and the ball's a good one. But if Mark Rieper follows Solskjaer, he doesn't score. He steps up, tries to play him offside. And what was said might happen if Manchester United get a good chance has happened. They've taken it.
Roped. Here flies forward for West Ham. Dumitrescu, they need him to sustain the work that he put in the first half, and it's terrific play from Dumitrescu.
Reminiscent of the sort of football we saw from him in the World Cup finals for Romania back in 94, but yeah. It hasn't always been seen in England.
Yeah, this is the sort of areas he did make his reputation, and this is what he does so well from that side. He'll always look to come in on his right side, it's the one he favours. He just shifts it once, then he shifts it again. He thought he was going to just turn it the other side of Pallister. Just didn't bend enough. Nearly, Harry. Les Sealy behind him as well. Animated.
Phil Neville. Oh, look at Beckham. Left unattended. But even so, that was exquisite.
Well, when many people might have been expecting the power, Beckham shows us the other side of his character. A beautiful, delicate chip. Great vision and awareness. And if he's got a touch on Solskjaer's, well, he's got no chance of getting anywhere near this. Gets under his feet a little, and that made his mind up, I think. Didn't get it out of the way he would have liked. We're talking about first touch, and this isn't the best, because it stays under his feet, sticks under there. So he didn't dig it out beautifully.
Well, it hasn't been his best game in truth, but he's still illuminated the afternoon.
Right, you don't save them, do you?
You just don't save them.
show there's still life in this game, and there is. West Ham have scored. Florian Raduchoy took it superbly.
What a finish, just what I said, they look so comfortable. This team, if someone slips, there's no way to recover. It goes across, Jones is the wrong side for my money as a defender. He wanted to be on the inside, not the out. I don't think he should be getting caught on the outside, but I tell you what, from then on, that's a great finish. Made for him on his right side. Just watch the way he measures this. He knows exactly what he wants to do. He's looking up, he's picking his spot, he's side-footing it, he's bending it. It's beautiful.
And it's his first goal in the Premiership, and it's come against Manchester United. And it's come at a vital time. We said at half-time, the best of the game was still to come, and that might still be the case now as it's set up for a terrific finale. The crowd will back West Ham all the way here. Dumitrescu. Out comes Schmeichel. Peter Jones says penalty against the goalkeeper. Michael Hughes scored. Schmeichel can't believe it. And West Ham have a chance extraordinarily to level the game within a matter of moments of getting their first goal.
Wow, what an amazing game football is. 2-0 up and cruising. And within 2 minutes, a chance to level it. I think it's a penalty. My first impressions were a penalty. You commit yourself as Peter Schmeichel did. Don't get the ball and take a player. And I think there's only one result, and that's a penalty. Now, will this be power? It normally is.
What a responsibility on the shoulders of Julian Dix. There's all sorts of jostling going on the edge of the area, which won't help the penalty taker.
And I don't think it will phase him too much more.
The goalkeeper who gave away the penalty now has the chance to preserve Manchester United's lead. But Dix crashes it past him. And the whole complexion has changed here so dramatically. 2-2.
Well, I said I thought it would be power. And power it certainly was. He could have gone the right way, Peter Schmeichel. He still wouldn't have got across to save that. He did go the right way. Well, it was past him in a block. Absolutely fizzed past him. And now a game that looked lost 5 minutes ago is there to be won.
Everything fortunately for him, but level for him. West Ham have got a free kick. And they're not sending too many players forward, but they might think about getting one or two in the box now, because this is Ilya Dumitrescu. A deflection, and Schmeichel had to go across in any case. Oh, for a second I thought that was a West Ham winner.
Well, it was always sneaking past the post, I thought, but Schmeichel didn't know that. He had to get across. Had it ricocheted in the other corner, may have been different.
I think there was as much trying to stop the corner as anything, Peter Schmeichel there.
Hughes with the corner. Dix coming in. Hughes again. Dumitrescu. It's a great effort, terrific stop. And the flag has gone up. And when West Ham thought they might get another penalty, Manchester United get a free kick for the offside.
Well, had it not been offside, they might well have been a great case for a penalty. This is a wonderful effort. A very tight decision. Not when the flag went up, couldn't quite see Mark. This went up for the shot, and that was a really tight decision.
Neville. Beckham. The cross goes out, the flag is up in any case. Another look at the watch from the referee. There's still time. West Ham egged on, but it's all over. A mundane first half in truth, a marvellous second half,